Hello everybody, we are back with round number 3. This time I'm joined by Marco Spartano. Hey Marco.
Hello there.
How are you doing? How are you feeling? Are you excited?
I'm alright. It's a pretty big game, you know, for a pretty big tournament. We got here Stefan Ivanov, and he's playing his, you heard it here the first time, Morpheko VMAX deck. Playing it with the Chinchino engine, a lot of electro powers, a lot of lightning energies. And this deck is quite a surprise to see here today. You see him playing against, I think, a traditional Blacephalon. What do you think? We started with a Blacephalon.
Yeah.
Use the GX right away.
Yeah, I'm checking the list right now.
Okay, like if you we're watching right now as well the Stefan Ivanov list, and you see he plays this very heavy Chinchino engine, 4/4 Chinchino, and 2/2 Morpheko. In order to have, like, you know, these two attackers, this which is a very big attacker as well. I think he has about 300 HP, the Morpheko VMAX, and he's obviously gonna do the spread attack once he needs it, or otherwise he's just gonna use those dolls and the Morpheko V attack, which makes him switch back to the bench.
Yep, it's a deck that Stefan was pretty vocal about.
Yes.
But he never brought it to a tournament, and now he probably decided it's the time for it. Since we saw a lot, he faced a lot of Obstagoon at the last qualifier, which was a very unfortunate matchup for his BB Blacephalon deck. So I guess now he switched to his second favorite deck of the format, thinking that it's better suited to deal with the mill decks with the Obstagoons, and maybe even with mirror matches. Also, maybe it's just a deck he enjoys, so he wants to try it. And
indeed, it's a very fun deck. You know, when you're playing something that is not meta, you have also this, you know, this feeling of coolness, because I'm playing the anti-meta deck. I'm playing the cool deck. Everyone, look at me. And it's well-deserved, because this is a very hard deck to pilot, I think, as well. You need to be very mindful of your resources, and this deck needs a lot of setup. And as we see in this list, 4/4 Chinchino, as well as 4 Tapu Koko V.
Yep, and he will be playing against Eli Hjörtur. I probably pronounce that terribly, so let's just say Eli.
It's okay.
With a classical Blacephalon deck, Blacephalon Naganadel, like we've seen it in a lot in the past, but it has gone relatively unpopular. It's become relatively unpopular recently.
You're right. Yeah, I think it's because of the advent of the baby version of the deck.
Yep.
It's been quite hard to, you know, to play that same deck, which had loses against its baby version, and is possibly worse because it needs more setup. As we see, like the last turn, he had just to pass again for the second turn in a row, in order to just try to set up, but he didn't find a supporter.
Yep.
Let's see if he can get out of this sticky situation.
Yeah, one thing that's pretty interesting is that Eli's not playing any gusting effects except one Great Catcher.
And wow. Stefan,
yeah,
wow.
Stefan having this hit and run strategy built into his deck might be...
It's gonna be hard.
Yep, this might make it really hard to get through all those little Poké Dolls.
This puppy doll is really hard. Oh, there's a Pokemon catcher actually.
Wait.
There's the flip effect. You might have missed that, but that's fine.
Oh, yeah, yeah, okay, yeah. I'm blind. It's two Pokemon catcher foes. So.
I know, it's because when you see Pokemon catcher, you're not thinking like,
yeah.
Pokemon catcher? Who plays that? But we need to come to the realization that it's a meta card now, and it's a pretty good one at that.
Yeah, also.
So we see him taking the knockout on the Poké Doll, and, you know, that's one less Poké Doll in the deck, but. Blacephalon also lost this energy. It's in the last one now. So, how do you think these decks fare up against each other? Do you think Stefan is advantaged?
Yeah, I think Stefan should be in a pretty good spot. He can afford to use some time on his setup, maybe hide behind dolls, and I think he can use his hit and run strategy to get through the crucial turns and just win times. Win time by putting up something like a Minchino or maybe a doll. And then he also has the one-shot option with Morpheko VMAX and Tapu Koko V. So I think there's a lot of things going in Stefan's favor.
Exactly. Do you think he will go for the knockout? Yes, he actually goes for the knockout thanks to that Thunder
Just
Mountain.
All in.
200 damage.
Let's go. He sees his opponent is stumbling a lot, only has 3 cards in his hand, basically.
Indeed.
Yeah, just with Lone Poipole on the board. And yeah, so he just goes with an aggressive path.
And I think he's right in that, because if his opponent does not have any basic Pokemon, it's just game. He's gonna... actually, I think the Tapu Koko needs to retreat in order to back to the next turn, but he can just Volkner and get a switch from it.
Yeah,
or just retreat and pocket also, put
exactly.
it at the bottom, and Tapu can attack again. Oh, actually has a Cherish Ball. The game is not gonna
yep.
finish yet.
And there's one Dedenne in the deck, so hopefully that is not priced and we can see a deck. Oh, a Naganadel GX.
Oh, he goes for a Naganadel GX.
Yep. Also,
maybe the
Dedenne
is even there. So unfortunate. Ultra Conversion, that's good. There's a Poipole. He needs to Beastring this turn. He is in range, so if he's able to, I think he has a chance, especially if he's able to attack in the same turn.
Yep, for sure.
So let's see what he goes for. There's a Mysterious Treasure, discarding another Fire Energy. Obviously, those fires this turn will not do much, because there's no Naganadel that can calm down this turn. There's the Poipole,
mm-hmm.
but he needs something consistent, he needs something big.
Yeah, he definitely needs a supporter at the very least, but it doesn't look like it. Just
yeah,
he
wouldn't. He's not played it yet. Let's see. What's his supporter count, actually?
Four Welder for sure, then there's two Cynthia, and I think that's it. Oh no, two Professors Research as well. So two
Cynthia,
Professor
Research.
Two Research.
Great card. So we see a Beastring from him. Let's see where he goes on from here. It's pretty, as I said, it's a sticky situation for him, because if he doesn't have supporter, that's very, very bad.
For sure.
At least if he could be able to attack with this Naganadel, I'm not sure how much he could do. At least it's something to put, you know, putting some pressure on the opponent. So right now, Stefan is completely unchallenged.
Yeah, at least maybe taking out a Cincino or something to take away some of Stefan's consistency. Because if Stefan's already ahead, so if he has his consistency and if he's able to, like, go for his game plan the entire time, then he will probably
yeah.
win this. So taking out a Cincino, not the worst thing to do here.
Yeah, it's really, you know, if the game keeps going and his opponent is able to catch up,
okay, this
maybe he can actually do four. He does 170
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, but this is
more
probably the game. Stefan has Electro Power in his hand.
Exactly, exactly.
He can just retreat.
Can knock it out.
Exactly, retreat. Put
and he will be out of range of Beastring as well.
Yep.
Which is going to be very hard for him to catch up on it.
Especially since he has zero cards in his hand. So with no cards in hand, just a Poipole on board and being down 5-2 prizes. Yeah, it's probably not anything.
Even
not something
this make do keep piling up as well. So he keeps getting set up. Wow, it's really tough. If there is a comeback in this deck, game, I would be very surprised.
Yeah, for
sure.
So
let's go. Let's see what else he has. He still has that Volkner. I think he plays just one copy of Switch, but it doesn't matter because he can just Tapu Koko and put the pocket all at the bottom.
Yep.
Retreat of zero. Very good card. No weakness, no resistance, I think. And as well, no retreat cost. No, it does have a weakness, actually, to fighting. So let's see. Retreat. Where's the pocket all? And we'll see a knockout this turn. Wow,
yeah.
It's as we said, it's very tough, but look at the Stefan hand as well. He has two custom catchers. So in case the opponent puts down an Blacephalon, it's going to be very complicated for him to get out.
Yeah, Stefan almost forgot to play that Electro Power, but did just in time. And now taking the knockout, and this is basically sealing the game. I don't see Elite having any comeback option, really.
Eye opener. I think he needs to, and he opened his eyes to understand that this game is over. Let's see. Oh, we actually see the Morpeko VMAX attacking. And there we go. Max Discharge, Armakalela Puppy, and 180 damage. Well played.
Yep.
There's the knockout.
Very convincing way for Stefan's Morpeko deck.
Indeed.
I'll check quickly to see what the starting times of the other pools were, so maybe we can show another game.
This game was quite fast, so I think it's very possible. But we saw that even like when a really good player such as Stefan pilots this kind of deck, which is, you know, not a meta deck, but definitely something that can work, we see how much powerful it can be when in the right hands.
Yep, and it looks like pool 3 is a bit behind, so we can probably change to a game from that. So,
I'm double checking right now. Who's in there?
Okay.
Let's see if Ross is in here.
Yeah, Ross should be there. Yeah, we will go to a quick break, and then we might be back with another round shortly. So don't go anywhere as we try to set up another